King Ross is bust. 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 King Ross is bust.
No, you're not, you little bastard!
King Ross, here's King Ross, here's King Ross, here's King Ross. And here's your friend, here's your friend.
It's John O'Clock, motherfuckers! I cannot believe it! Get the fuck in there! Anyway, I'm gonna have to read this off me sheet because this cap has affected my mind. It's reduced it to the size of some bodies that would actually wear one of these in normal day life. Aye, I didn't like these hats, but you know, I'm a sick guy anyway. Get this though, right? This was a sentence that came out of JBL's mouth while speaking about Randall Keith Orton. Yeah, and it looked like last week he had hurt that shoulder in the match against that he had. Against that he had, there's a superstar called that he had. That's a shit superstar name, isn't it? Probably the worst I've ever heard. I'm not bitter about your blockers on Twitter, John. Honest, I swear to God. I'm guessing that Alberto Del Rio has forgotten what the warmth and feel of a human body feels like after Paige was drafted to Raw and he was drafted to SmackDown. He's sleeping in his bed alone at night. Ha, ha, ha. Boom! Yeah! That, my friends, was a hashtag hat bomb. You can expect more of them in the coming weeks. Because I'm balls. Paul Ellering and the NXT Universe's reaction to him has given me the best moment of the night so far. Who would have thought this, right? It's John O'Clock on NXT and he's not even on the show! God, I could not be happier. Oh! JBL took to Twitter to say that it was a huge pop for Ellering turning up, even though there wasn't. There was nothing, it was crickets. The crowd even was saying, "Who are you?" at Paul. Poor Paul. John then followed that up by saying that pop was just from John himself. Nah, no, you can't go back on that one, John, you stupid idiot. Tell you what, that John O'Clock entry was a bit fancy, wasn't it? Big Bob Dahlstrom made that for me. Nice, isn't it? Get used to seeing that. I know you love it though, Maggle. What on earth was Andrade Cien Almas wearing during his entrance? He looked like the result of an orgy between the Godfather, Armando Estrada, and someone who wore braces in WWE history who I can't quite remember the name of. Owen Hart, maybe? Anyway, he looks sh**. Good God almighty, motherfuckers, it's John O'Clock once again, and did you hear him dropping incest jokes about Heath Slater? Not only John was doing it, mine, but David Otunga was getting in on the whole cousin-wife shite. How dare you, John? How very dare you, David? WTF happened to Rusev's bicep? Now prepare yourself, ladies, the gun show's about to come out. Basically, Rusev's bicep started Heather, and it just took a massive dip. There. As big a dip as WWE's ratings have taken in recent times, eh? That's a good one, isn't it?
Time for the first WTF moment, and it concerns Ross's favourite, Kevin. Oh, Kevin, what have you done? I'm trying to be King Ross, if you can't tell. Basically, at the start of the event, the club enter, big cheer because it's AJ Styles, he's over as hell, and then the boos just cascade through because Kevin can't do an episode of SmackDown without tampering with the stuff, can he, Kevin?
Randy, man, piss off back to Viperville, will you? Because I've got one thing to say to you, bunny lad. F*** you! Right, that's it. That's all your WTF moments from WWE Battleground. Oh, I'll see you tomorrow for all then, will I? And on Wednesday for SmackDown, Thursday for WCPW Built to Destroy. There's a lot of f***ing things coming this week, so brace yourselves. Bye.